Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name is Leigh Fuge and I'm here today with musicteacher.com. And in this video, we're going to talk about some basics of theory. We're going to start by talking about the theory behind major chords. So that little chord progression you heard me play at the start of this video was just made up of three major chords, an A, a D, and an E major. Now, the type of chord isn't really important at this point. We're going to talk about what makes a major chord. So if you've never done any theory before, this is a great place to start. All of the guitar tones you're hearing in this video today are coming from my PRS S2 Studio, which is plugged into the Blackstar Studio 10 6R6, and the amp is running via the Two Notes Torpedo Captor X today. My voice is being recorded with the Sennheiser MKE400 microphone. So in this lesson, we're going to talk about major chords. I'm going to talk about the theory behind making a major chord. This is really useful if you're just starting out with learning theory. Understanding chord theory is very useful because it allows you to then build upon that and turn simple major chords into any other type of chord you want. But to start with that, you need to understand the basics of what makes a major chord. So when we start learning guitar, we learn major chords by their shape. So we're told if we put our fingers in this position, it's an A major. If we put our fingers in this position, it's a D major. Or perhaps a C major. But there is an underlying theory that ties all of this together, and this is why major chords sound the way they sound. So to figure that out, we need to reference what's called the major scale. Now this is, in my opinion, the gateway into all music theory. So if you understand the major scale, you can pretty much understand anything theory-based because this all links back to the major scale. So the major scale I'm going to play is the A major scale. So what I'm playing here is an 8-note phrase. I'm playing the 5th and 7th frets on the low E string, the 4th, 5th, and 7th on the A string, and the 4th, 6th, and 7th on the D string. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take that scale shape and we're going to put notes to it. So A and B, C sharp, D and E, F sharp, G sharp, and A. Now we're going to put numbers to it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. You'll notice when I said about notes, this final note here was an A, which is also the same as this note. That's the reason we've gone with number 1 for that. So the notes there are the notes of the frets that I'm playing, but the numbers are what are known as intervals. Intervals are essentially just a numbering system that allow us to identify degrees of a scale or chord. They're used a lot through different theory concepts. So what we've done there is we've taken the notes of the major scale, worked out what the note is, and then we've assigned a number to that note, numbers 1 through 7. This is what makes a major scale. This is useful to know because if I'm playing a major scale in another position, intervals are still the same. So the notes are still going to be numbered the same way, but the notes underneath the numbers are going to be the note of the fret. So if I was to play that scale in the 8th fret position, that would be C major, but the intervals would still be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. So the intervals just allow us to identify specific notes or degrees within the scale. Now the reason I'm telling you this is because we're going to use this scale to construct a chord. So a major chord, doesn't matter where you play the major chord on the guitar, it's only ever made up of 3 different notes. Now, when we play an A major chord, like this, we're actually playing 5 notes at the same time. But inside of that, there's actually only 3 notes. We're playing a couple of duplicates there. So every single major chord in existence can be worked out from the major scale that it comes from. So we're going to use the A major scale again. The notes that make up a major chord are the 1, the 3, and the 5. And this is now why the intervals are important. Because now we can go back to the scale. The 1 was this note. The 3 was the 3rd note of the scale. And the 5 was the 5th note of the scale. So this is the reason why the intervals are useful, because if we're talking about a different chord other than an A, we can still work out what those notes are just by moving the major scale to the new position. So if I wanted to work out the notes of a C major chord, I'd shift my A note to a C and do my major scale from there. And then I take the first, third, and fifth notes. So we're going to start with A, though, as our starting point. So A major is only made up of the first, the third, and the fifth notes of the A major scale. So if we go through the scale and work out what those notes are, so A is the first note, B is the second note, so we don't need to worry about that, but the third note is a C sharp, the fourth note is a D, so we're not using that, but the fifth note is an E. So that gives us A, C sharp, and E. Now if I go and play my A major chord, and then I look at each note of that chord, I should only have A, C sharp, and E notes. So the first note is an A. Then we've got an E. Then we've got another A. Then we've got a C sharp. And then we've got another E. So that chord is only made up of A, C sharp, and E notes. Now let's test that theory with another chord. Let's take a C major chord. And then we'll check out the C major scale. So the C major scale is going to start from the 8th fret of the low E string. So we're going to do that same scale shape. Give it the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. Then we're going to work out the notes. C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. Now we're going to look at the first, the third, and the fifth notes. So the first note was a C. The third note was an E. And then the fifth note is a G. So we've got C, E, and G. So what we should now see is if we play a C major chord, we should only have C, E, and G notes. So the first note of the chord is a C. The second note of the chord is an E. The third note of the chord is a G. The fourth note of the chord is also a C. And the fifth note of the chord is an E. So when I extract those three notes from the scale, so in A, A, C sharp, and E, or in C, it was C, E, and G, that's known as a major triad, the 1, the 3, and the 5. This theory carries across all major chords all over the guitar. So we mentioned that a C major was a C, E, and a G. If I was to play a C major chord as a bar chord from the 8th fret of the low E string, we'd still have the same notes. Even though I'm now playing six notes at the same time, this is still only going to be made up of C, E, and G notes. So we've got C, G, C, E, G, and C. So the chord is still only stacked up with those three notes, but there are duplicates of each note. The bar chord version of a C there, for instance, has three C notes, two G notes, and a single E note. But when I play it in this position, the open position, I have two Cs, two E's, and a single G, but it's still the same three notes at play. So this is true for all major chords. This is how major chords are built. So if you're trying to work out the notes from any major chord, take that major scale shape, put it from the root note of the chord you're looking to work out. So let's say you're doing a G, so you'd start that shape from a G. Work out what the notes are in that scale, then work out the first, third, and fifth notes. And then when you then play that chord, you'll notice that it's only made up of those three notes. So this is really useful because as you go down the rabbit hole with chord theory, you can extend on this concept and turn this into other chords. But understanding that major chords are made up from a 1, a 3, and a 5 is the essential starting point for chord theory. The important note in this is the third note. This is the note that makes it major or minor. So in this case, we're playing what's called a major third, but there's also what's called a minor third, and we're going to cover that in a later video. But understanding where this note is and how to change it is a big, big, and very important part in understanding chords and how chords are created. So once you've gotten your head around the 1, 3, 5 that makes up major chords, then you can start branching this out to other chords, which we're going to do in more videos very soon. You can try this out yourself as well with other major chords. So take your D major, for instance, or your E major, play the major scale starting from that note, take the 1, the 3, and the 5, learn what they are, then look at the chord. The chord should only be made up from those 3 notes. So there's a quick overview of how major chords are constructed. If there are any other theory concepts you'd like to see us talk about in videos, please let us know down below in the comments, and also let us know how you've gotten on with understanding your major chords with this method. Don't forget to check out PMTVUK on YouTube for more video lessons just like this. And if you're looking for a music teacher in your local area, please check out musicteacher.com. There's a network of great teachers all around the country. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.